On the line, the WBC number one ranking in the world, Jose Luis El Elotero Zertupe. The winner by knockout victory, now ranked number one in the world by the World Boxing Council, still undefeated.
A 3-inch height advantage for Pavlik, who at 6'2 is very tall for the middleweight division, but an arm length advantage, conversely, of 1.5 inches for Miranda, measured from the armpit to the end of the fist. They both weighed in at the official division limit of 160. Miranda rehydrating overnight to 173.
And now here comes Kelly Pavlik, who is from Youngstown, Ohio, a city with a tremendous past sports tradition.
All different styles are always coming at me.
Big right hand.
Oh, that hurt him. He's out.
Miranda is down. And the question is, can he make it up?
Yes.
I don't think he's going to make it.
Well, he's on his feet.
He's definitely wobbling.
Is he going to let him go on?
Yeah, Smoker will let him go on. Absolutely. I've seen Smoker away.
He's giving him too much time. What's going on here?
Back the mouth.
Smoker is
now he's
giving himself the advantage.
Well, to be fair, you know, he dropped his mouth guard, so he really has to put back his mouth guard.
He's gone anyway. He just got hit with a massive left hook. And Lennox Lewis is correct. He's going to have a tremendous amount of difficulty recovering from this. He's going to make it up again. And I'm betting Smoker lets him keep going.
Look, right again.
Knockdowns in the round.
Miranda's legs don't steam there. Seem like they're there.
And the bell saves him from the carnage of that round. It must be very difficult now for him to watch his fighter wobble around the ring. His right eye swings it, and this is stoppage time. Any other referee would have stopped it before there. Smoker finally does. Kelly Pavlik has a huge knockout victory.
And now we have a build-up to a fight with Taylor. That could be huge, huge, huge. The main event of the evening. 12 rounds of boxing for the universally recognized middleweight championship of the world. And now, undefeated challenger versus undefeated champion. Somebody's O has gotta go. Professional record, 28 bouts without a loss. He's the fighting pride of Little Rock, Arkansas, the universally recognized, undefeated, reigning, defending, middleweight champion of the world, Jermaine, bad intentions.
Is Kelly Pavlik. If you saw the countdown show that helped to set up this fight, it established the kind of intensity that is shown there as Taylor suddenly gets Pavlik in big trouble. Kelly Pavlik getting raked by the arms right now. And now Pavlik goes down.
That is it.
That was a tremendous barrage from Jermaine Taylor. That was the best offensive show in Taylor's last six fight. He's going to make it out of the second round, it appears.
We have witnessed one of the great middleweight championship bouts in boxing history. Referee Steve Smoker steps in, calls a halt at 2 minutes, 14 seconds, round number 7. The winner by TKO victory and new undefeated middleweight champion of the world, Kelly, the Ghost.
your thought process?
You really want to know what I thought? Shit, this is going to be a long night.
If Jermaine Taylor can somehow put all thoughts of the seventh round out of his mind and go into this fight with legitimate, clean confidence and self-belief, he's still got the physical goods to beat Kelly Pavlik and win the fight. But I'm extremely doubtful that you can do that. You know, if he can do that, all power to him. But I think the odds are against that kind of experience.
Meanwhile, Kelly Pavlik's emergence out of the Midwestern Rust Belt was fortified by a hardened attitude and an even harder right hand.
This is stoppage time. Kelly Pavlik has a huge knockout victory.
The winner by TKO victory.